Hey guys, it's Phoenix. Today I wanted to talk about 1.13's update Aquatic, which should drop roughly 12 hours from this video's release. So once you see this video, there's a good chance that 1.13's already been released. So tonight I will be live streaming, hopefully to get to the release of this. Check the description if you guys want to catch up on everything. So I'm not going to actually talk about all of the content because that will take way too long. So you can see some of the things that I have marked for myself, which I think are just really important and don't actually get addressed in this article. Okay, so here you can see, first of all, the blocks. So air variants don't actually matter too much. This is just in terms of internal work for the game. There is actually a cave air and void air block though, but you won't notice anything different. Blue ice, of course, is the new variant that you can see from icebergs. They are very slippery, but of course they have been toned down ever since they became somewhat game-breaking. Bubble columns, marble blocks when placed inside water will drag things down, soul sand drag things up, which I think should be the other way around because marble blocks give off heat, but that's just part of the game. There's a lot of decorative stuff in this update, of course, because the overhaul of the underwater requires some new blocks. I'm not going to talk about those. And of course, while you are exploring the underwater, you'll see those anyway. The first stop here is, of course, the conduits. Now, not really correlated well with the requirements of their crafting recipe. I do think they could be improved a little bit still, but they are very useful in terms of allowing you to mine stuff underwater, use the underwater environment for building, because they take away your need to breathe underwater. Okay, so ignoring the soul sand at the top, you need, I think, 42 prismarine bricks or some variant of prismarine. You can look it up yourself. But once you build it in this way, it will extend almost 100 blocks in range and give you conduit power, which essentially means you don't need to breathe and you can mine, place blocks, you know, swim around without worrying about drowning. And the tweaking I still recommend as of this snapshot is that it should definitely kill mobs at a wider range. Right now the radius is 8 blocks. So if I place a creeper here, it won't actually get hurt. So the crafting recipe for this conduit block is actually not that easy to get. The Heart of the Sea, which is the item in the middle, also needs to have its texture fixed, by the way. It is not that easy to find because you actually need to find an ocean ruin, which will give you a map for a treasure map, which will locate some treasures that are hidden inside terrain. So you can't actually find them yourself unless you get really lucky, but they spawn in only those areas. So really hard to find. You also need to get Nautilus shells, which can be found from fishing, but of course the fishing loot table is already quite sizable as it is today. So again, not that easy. Not gonna talk about the coral blocks, coral fans, dead coral blocks. They're all really just decorative. I'm gonna jump down here to kelp, and kelp is that thing that you find everywhere. Because it's been really buggy lately. And so here is kelp in action, and the random tick speed is now set to a really high number, 10,000. So it's just like reeds, sugarcane, and you don't actually need shears for this. I just have it with me because you do need it for other underwater stuff. Here we go. And there we go. You can actually see them dropping now. So that being said, they're actually really easy to grow yourself. It's just like sugarcane. So again, not really that important of an item here. They just appear a lot. Anyway, continuing, seagrass can be used with shears, obtained with shears, and you need seagrass to breed turtles. So that's way more important than kelp. And of course, turtles are useful because they give you another potion, and they have this entirely new gameplay aspect, which is linked to phantoms, which is the only link I can find to phantoms for this appropriate inclusion in this update, right? So turtles, I'll talk about them in a moment. Sea pickles, not really that important. Shulker boxes, whatever, there's a new undyed shulker box. Strip bark, strip logs for building, and turtle eggs. I've made a video on it, which I'll link in description if you're interested, but turtle eggs hatch into turtles, and they hatch at nighttime only, I believe. I don't really think that's really true, because I've seen turtle eggs hatch in the daytime. I think they're more likely to hatch in the nighttime, or they grow faster, or they are incubated a lot more efficiently during nighttime, which is why I'm saying it's linked to phantoms, which is what Lady Agnes said in that interview with Doc M. So be careful, don't trample on them. There's like a 35 to 40% chance that they will break if you trample on them. I've done the experiment myself. All right, it's time for me to jump into a world to demonstrate this inclusion of ocean ruins, shipwrecks, and everything. So ocean ruins are found like so, and you can find them quite easily if you're near an ocean environment. You can also use locate now and locate ocean ruin. Just click on this and you can teleport to it immediately. Just press enter. More importantly, and with the drowned mobs that you're seeing inside, there are chests inside here which are full of goodies, as you can see. They are sometimes filled with goodies. The buried treasure map is what you are really looking for. This is your position right now. So what I'm gonna do is travel a little bit further down here. You can see an iceberg here, very convenient, with all the packed ice. The blue ice is actually underneath, more likely to spawn down here. There we go, there's some blue ice. They spawn underneath. So I'm gonna look for this and I'll be right back. You can just see the immense chunk lag that still exists in 1.13, it's really bad. Okay, so now that I can finally find my marker on this map, the treasure map shows me that it's somewhere down here. And you'll notice that they, more often than not, show up in the shoreline or in a beach. That's where they are usually found. So I've overshot a little bit. So there's a chest somewhere here. There we go. And there's the Heart of the Sea, among a lot of other stuff. Which, this is a very good chest. And these chests actually do contain a lot of goodies. And they'll always contain a Heart of the Sea. So once you find one, you can grab it. You can grab a conduit for yourself. Debug stick, a really cool item. I've made a video about it as well, and I think it's one of the coolest items in this update. I'm gonna demonstrate on this turtle egg here. You can use it, you can only give it with this command, and I believe it only works in creative mode. I can actually show this right now. Yeah, it only works in creative mode, and in fact, what you can do with it is alter the properties of any block that allows it to have properties changed. So I can change the number of eggs for this turtle egg, and you can see it actually flash through like this. One of the coolest things you can do with the debug stick is in fact use it on a redstone lamp. You just right click it once and set its lit property to true or false, just like that. The only problem being it updates if you block update it. Okay, fish bucket. So what you can do is right click on a block. You can't actually right click water like this. You gotta right click on a block to release fish, and you can use a water bucket like so to recollect them, and you'll get fish like this, and you get a new advancement, whatever. But you can collect fish with a water bucket, just make sure you swim directly to it, and then you can create your own aquariums like that. Heart of the Sea, kelp, mushroom blocks, I'm not going to talk about any of this. Petrified oak slab is just a stone slab, but the wooden slab doesn't actually burn. It's like those really old properties that you would normally have. Phantom membranes, dropped by phantoms when they're killed, can be used to repair elytra and used for slow falling potions. Now, I'm going to talk about the slow falling and potion of Turtle Master at this instance. First of all, I just want to demonstrate this really cool thing that you can do with item frames now. You haven't been paying attention. You can place them on the bottoms and tops of blocks, which is really cool. If you want to create a potion of slow falling, you'll put a phantom membrane here with an awkward potion here. And of course, you need your blaze powder here. And if you wanted to create a potion of the turtle master, you'll put your turtle head, which is this thing. The phantom is really just there to help you with elytra flying, which, again, shouldn't really be in this update, but it was tied together with the Minecon Earth vote. Let me just grab one here so I can actually prove it. So this gives you slowness 4, resistance 3, a highly defensive item. I don't know why you would ever want this. It can be useful though in some respects if you are, you know, not planning to move a lot or a great deal when you're PvPing something. This gives you resistance 3, which is, you know, really defensive. But otherwise, a very useful item anyway. Perfectly apt in terms of the relationship to turtles. To craft a turtle shell, you need these items, which are scutes, and scutes can be found when a baby turtle grows into an adult turtle. Gonna skip over this. Tridents, a new item that can be dropped from Drowned. Very overpowered item. They are basically gonna replace bows once you have a trident which has loyalty on it. So here's what a trident looks like. You can enchant them with your whatever. Impaling just gives it more strength. I'll talk about this more once I get to the enchantments page. But man, tridents are very, very strong. Dolphins, I still think they need some reworking. They still move a little funny in the water. Have been fixed for the most part. Dolphins can be fed raw cod. They don't breed though, but they will lead you to a treasure chest. One of those ocean ruin ones or the shipwreck ones. They'll lead you relatively slowly, but otherwise that's their only use right now. They play with items. They sometimes jump around. They give the player dolphin's grace. If you're around 5 to 10 blocks around it, and that gives you some swim boost, so you can swim a little bit faster. Okay, drowned, you've already seen them. They appear once a zombie drowns. They do spawn though, naturally. They hold tridents and you can kill them to get the trident. Basically, there's just another version of zombies underwater. Fish mobs, purely decorative. They have nothing to do with fishing, and you can grab them with a bucket. Of course, puffer fish will cause you to get poisoned once you are near them. Phantoms. My gosh, not really that good of a mob for the game. Just don't make sense in this update. They do obviously have some impact on you if you don't sleep, but I've faced phantoms myself. They are nothing but annoying. I mean, that could be something in the game, but do you really want annoying mobs that fly around if you don't sleep, but they don't really hurt you that much? They hit you, they fly away, they hit you again. They have the same behavior as Ender Dragons, so it's like they just copy-pasted the code for it. Turtles, already talked about them, love their addition to the game. They're brilliant. Okay, world generation. They have removed the customized world option. They are now replaced with buffet mode, which is still inchoate, which still needs some work. They've just left it half done for this update. So I think they do need to quickly work on this to give us the customized feel again. Otherwise, this is just talking about the biome changes, the names, I guess, nothing else. But the customized world generation is now gone. It's now with buffet mode, which is over here. So let's go to single player, create new world, creative, buffet, right here. You can change it to overworld, caves, floating. Caves is basically the nether, really. And floating islands is basically the end. But you can customize your very own biomes for this. It's very stagnant right now, and that needs to be worked on. The channeling enchantment summons a lightning bolt every time a trident makes impact with a mob, but it needs to be during a thunderstorm. It cannot just be raining. Impaling is basically, I guess, a sharpness or like power for the trident. Loyalty allows the trident to come back, and you can play around with this level in creative mode or as an operator. You can cheat and give it like really high loyalty enchantment. Otherwise, it just allows it to come back to you. So this is a very nice enchantment and something that you really want. It's like infinity. And Riptide allows you to launch yourself, which is really cool. Map marker is not going to talk about that. It's really just a map making thing. You can edit maps to have like markers on them. I've made a video on it too. You can create really cool artwork in that way, I guess. Movement, you may have already noticed this everywhere. Swimming now makes you swim. So your hitbox is changed to as if you are flying on an Elytra and you can fit through one block gaps. So that's all that I'm going to discuss in terms of gameplay. Now let's talk about the technical aspects. I do plan on making a full video in depth talking about all the command changes, but I'm going to show you some of the things that I think you guys would really like about this. First of all, I'm going to jump back into the flat world, my test world. If you do anything with commands, you will see a very nice dinner bone menu. So you can use the execute command, and that will basically allow you to understand essentially what to do. And this is very useful if you are learning commands, or especially in 1.13 where everything is new. Even I use this a lot now. And this has really helped me get accustomed to the new execute feature. So execute store result, let's say score at P, jump, and I can do anything now. You can grab the data from a player and store them into a scoreboard. That's one of my favorite, probably the favorite change. Essentially, with this update in 1.13, commands are now more simplified and you don't need as many commands to do certain things. One of the biggest inclusions is this NBT argument in target selectors. You no longer need to give scores to entities with an NBT because you can actually put that NBT into the target selector. Corners can now use this caret format, which will essentially mean where you're facing. Boss bars are really cool now. You can create your own boss bars. You can have multiple boss bars, change the name, change the display, change the style, and boss bars can essentially be used to show custom boss health. Data slash data is the new slash entity data or slash block data. Data packs allows you to customize your data packs and order them by priority, disable, enable them, like resource packs, but since you don't have a UI for data packs, you will need to use commands instead. Teleport now executes relative to the position of the executor. So what you need to do now instead is to use execute as the entity and then at the entity. So execute as creeper, at S is the quickest way to, you know, solve all these problems. New sounds. There are new sounds for the game, of course, with everything that's new. In particular, I really like this one. Very nice sound that they've added. The underwater ambience is perfect. I gotta say, with all the new music, all the new sounds, it really makes sense and it really gives that feel. Tags, this is going to be something that you might be familiar with. Minecraft tick allows a function to be run 20 times a second, so 20 hertz clock. It's just the alternative here. Vanilla tags, everything that will change the properties of blocks now, you can look through these yourself. Water physics are still very broken, so just don't worry too much if your farms are broken. They might still be tweaking things here. Some other changes that you might want to know about. Block IDs are now gone. They're now just word IDs. Everything is very straightforward though. Once you type it in, you'll know what's going on. In your F3 debug screen, you can actually see the targeted block. So if you're not familiar with the words there, that's totally fine. With resource packs, everything's also very straightforward. So it appears to me that every ID that you see in game, if you have the F3H tooltips on, Everything you see in-game will actually correspond directly to their name inside the resource pack. Execute has been changed a lot. So you can execute as an entity now to make them execute it. You can execute at their position. You often want to combine these two with at S at the end. You can position relative to a coordinate. You can now face entities. So you can execute a command as though the actual entity is looking at a certain entity. You can teleport to other dimensions now. Execute if is if a block is at a certain position or if an entity exists, which is very similar to as, but this is not executing as that entity. It's still executing relative to the function or yourself who's pressing the command. Stats is no longer relevant now because you've got execute store, which can store success counts or results of the subsequent command into a scoreboard objective. Everything now being truncated into a single term or single argument. Fill commands have changed, set block commands have changed, give commands have changed. So I can demonstrate this here. So give at p bow 1 0, there's no more damage value. So if you want to give yourself a bow with, it even hints it for you. If you want to give yourself a bow with a custom NBT, you just simply do something over here. So I've already made a command here for you guys. So if you want to give yourself a bow with a display name of ASDF, you're going to use JSON now. So you can see I put backslashes every time there's a double quotation mark. And then you can just give yourself the item name like that. So there you go. I've given myself an ASDF bow, which means you can now give yourself things with color as well. You can add that to the NBT. Slash seed now allows you to copy the output, which is really nice. And stop sound slash tag is now its own separate command. Slash team is now its own separate command. Teams can now have a prefix, similar to what I've shown you guys with boss bars as well. You can add, a prefix or suffix to your team name, which shows everywhere in chat and in tab as well. And then there's all the bug fixes at the bottom, which is, you know, substantial for this update because it's such a big update. That's all I'm going to talk about for this video. I do still want to make a video talking about some commands or maybe just summarizing everything that's changed there. But otherwise, hope you guys enjoy this update. I will be streaming tonight as usual. It is a huge update, so many changes, which I think you guys might be excited for. It's been a long time coming for this update, and hopefully Minecraft, or Mojang, I guess, keeps it going because this is a good step in the right direction. Still not the best update. There's still a lot of bugs that need to be fixed, but they have proven themselves to be, you know, putting a lot of effort still in this game, and this is something that I think the game has needed for a while. I guess caving is still a top priority anyway. Thank you all for watching. Hopefully this video helped you guys out. Subscribe for more creative content and news updates. Stay tuned for the live stream, and hopefully it will be released during that time. Take care.